Can you prove to me?
I've got a question for you.
They were disciples and they saw Jesus.
This way.
Are you just deflected my question?
I didn't deflect it. I heard it, and I'm asking you. Yeah, there you go.
You want me to?
You got the dates wrong, by the way.
What do you want me to prove? That they were disciples. Now these are the accounts of the scholars at that time. Now someone like myself has a belief in this book as being the truth and word of God. Why do I believe in this account? Because the Bible is very clear in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not bear false witness. We don't have the, we do not have the...
Can you repeat the first commandment?
The first commandment, love the Lord thy God. One second.
Thou shalt have no other God.
Exodus. Wait, let me not deflect. I'll go into that. It's a distraction because I'm trying to answer. But the first commandment is, thou shalt not have any other gods before me.
I just want to say something before you carry on.
This is the original.
There's a way to propagate your truth without being derogatory.
What, like without, off hands
all right.
That's the thing. You're
talking. Thank you.
One second. You're talking to a Muslim who has never cut anyone's feet.
But your God does.
Forget my God. Because you said Muslims.
We don't hug and kiss, do we?
One second, bro. The energy is wrong, bro. Wait. I'm not attacking. I'm saying is.
You've got a question.
There's a way.
That's a statement.
Yeah, the statement. Do you know why?
Because you have a statement.
I don't want to be disrespectful. I'm not going to sit here and say your Bible is this and that. I'm going to say your Bible is not credible, but I'm not going to say your Bible does this.
Let me explain something. Can I answer? So you're saying that there's a derogatory. You say there's a derogatory. No, one of the. Can I respond? I've listened to you, please. Okay, continue.
You're standing there saying me.
Yeah. Did I say you?
Hold on.
I said Islam, the Quran. I didn't say Muslim. No. Look, do not put words in my mouth. I really don't. I detest people that actually.
This is not.
I don't work like that. Honestly, sorry. I'm an individual. My name's Yakub. I have a way of Yakub. No. I said Muslims, they went into churches. No, I said ISIS members went into churches and bombed churches in Sri Lanka.
That's nothing to do with the Quran.
All right.
If you're fighting, it must be a war.
Quran 929. Have you read Quran 929?
I'll
answer your question. I will. No, he was actually. No. I'm going to answer your question. It's just that we don't want to free.
Whoa, bro! I'm quoting your scripture. Until they feel themselves humiliated and pay the jizya.
See, this is fight against those that don't believe in Allah on the last day. Why are we suffering? The tafsir will confirm it.
You've read the line. Have you taken the time to actually?
I've read the whole.
Yeah, we've read the tafsir. We've read the tafsir.
Have you taken the time to interpret what the words
no,
mean?
No, I went with an Islamic interpretation.
I went with Ibn Kathir's. I went with Ibn Abbas.
If you want to answer,
not the translation.
No, the tafsir.
Okay. So what's the tafsir? Can I just quickly address it? All right. There's tafsir Ibn Abbas. There's tafsir Ibn Kathir. I'm not here to do Islamic exegesis now, but it tells very clearly fight against the Christians. Muhammad in the Hadith, he also said. He also said he'll expel the Arabians. He said he'll expel the Christians and the Jews from Arabia. No, it's not one at a time. What you're doing is you're actually trying to debate me. I don't debate. I rebuke false doctrine. What you're trying to tell me is how to use my Bible when you don't know what.
My Bible. Your brain.
Well, hold on. Okay, you think I can't use my brain. Fantastic. So you wait, hold on. You'll start with the ad hominem, but I'll just go in. Timothy 3:16, rebuke false doctrine. Rebuke is a strong, sharp Hold on. I can rebuke false doctrine.
Listen,
I will read the Bible.
You have to use the Quran against me.
I don't need to use the Quran against you. I don't take orders from people that are complete strangers, that are actually lacking of intellect and knowledge of what I'm talking about. And they're just trying to make themselves into showmen for the camera because they probably have a very low, attitude towards this. But anyway, I am not going to be discussed. I'm speaking the truth. The truth sometimes hurts. All scriptures given by inspiration.
Second
Timothy 3:16. All scriptures given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction and instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect throughout. Our religion tells us specifically Islam is antichrist. No, it's anti-God. Our religion tells us Allah is Satan. My job as a Christian missionary is to warn Muslims for those that want to be changed. Those that reject the Bible, I'm to leave them alone. So if you want to reject the scripture, I leave you alone. No, I'm not here to fall. It's not a claim. I'm reading the scriptures. I will not get into ignorant arguments, so I've finished your day. So let's go into your...
Do you remember my question?
Yes, it was something about what is the proof of the disciples. Gospels. Now, the Gospels to us, and me that's a believer, we believe in the commandments of God. And one of the commandments is, thou shalt not bear false witness. Unfortunately, in Islam, Allah is called Al-Makkah. Wait, hold on. No, I'm giving my speech and you can respond. You have to understand. I've read it. I'll read Timothy again. 1 Timothy 3:16. A lot of Muslims here have this misconception. They feel that they can talk to us and then we have to be dimmy and mellow. But no, when I'm talking against an antichrist spirit, I am going to rebuke. I'm going to rebuke a false doctrine. I am not going to argue. I'm not going to debate. I'm going to rebuke. He's asked me, why are the disciples? Why do I believe? I've said it very specifically. The disciples and the account comes from the book of the scriptures. We've learnt that the scripture is profitable and is God-breathed. Now, over 3,500 years, 66 books were compiled to make this Bible. So we have an account of 40 men of God called prophets, including Moses, Isaiah, Micah, and he's not considered a prophet in the Bible. And we have other prophets, including Ezekiel. So these prophets all believe in not bearing false witness. So by not bearing false witness, they've given us an account of God. So what are the disciples going to gain lying that they are not the disciples of Christ? What do Christians have to gain by saying that Jesus Christ did not exist? What do we have to gain? We have nothing to gain but a deception to ourselves. We believe in Christ because we believe in salvation in heaven by believing in Christ. If we don't believe the account of the disciples, then we don't have faith. We are not like Muslims that in order for their prophet to have faith, an angel cut his belly and put a dish of wisdom. Faith in the Bible is belief in our Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God becoming flesh. So that is what our religion is based on that belief. Your faith is built on many multiple things.
I'd like to say something because I actually like work with this team.
Yes.
So what I'd like to say is Yakub's answer includes the... Bruv! But who's asking you? The point is that our survey says, right, anyway, the point is that if all scripture is God-breathed, you see this finger behind my back, right, the point is, yes, I am. The point is that if all scripture is, bruv, the point is, do you? Well, go and feel like it over there then. I'm going to answer you. We know that all books of the Bible, all scripture is God-breathed, as Yakub just pointed out. We have had 2,000 years of critiquing the Bible, of researching the Bible. We know that Matthew, I'm not lying, and okay, I care what you think. Hold on. No, I don't.
Right.
I don't know.
You can't answer this question.
Excellent. I'm trying to answer it, but you keep heckling because you're afraid of the truth. Because you don't have the truth in you.
Well, this is the Mohammedan cause. Let's go back to the persecution.
And no, let's also. Well. Let me give the people who are watching an answer. All scripture is God breathed. We know that Matthew was a tax collector. We know that Luke was a doctor. We know that John is the disciple that Christ loved. We know that Mark was certainly present at. Actually, it was written. Like sources. Peter was, it's in the Bible, dude. I haven't finished though, and it's quite rude to interrupt someone. Church fathers, Christ himself was represented by these people. If they had lied, they themselves would believe themselves to be going to hell. Their accounts have been verified. Of course you may.
Funny enough. Where's the evidence Muhammad existed?
Okay. I don't have any.
It's called a counter argument.
I've given you my answer.
Why? Can I have the give us some evidence.
We're talking about persecution. I'll give them to you afterwards. Just Google them.
I direct you.
I don't need direction. You didn't.
I'm here for persecution.
No, I'm not asking. I'm just throwing it out to show the silliness of the Mohammedan argument. Because guys are not trying to actually learn something.
Jacob, wait. Trying to stop.
I'm not Jacob. It's Yakub.
Okay, I got a question.
Thank you.
I've been listening.
Yes.
And I hear that...
I'll hold it.
Sorry, ask the question again. So,
yeah. So I've been listening and I hear that you're saying Allah, you know, is the devil.
According to the Bible. Now, according to the Bible, yeah.
Let's talk about Christianity.
Okay.
Many years ago, in America, so many Christian slave owners, enslaved Native Americans, half of them got killed because they didn't do anything.
Right, and who should judge them?
Is that Christian doctrine?
But
who should judge them? That guy got the answer right.
They're doing it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Were they doing it in the name of Jesus, the slave trade?
Well, they weren't using any verses about give up your slaves. We are going to treat your slaves as brothers.
What verse?
Crusaders.
Which verse? The Crusades were a defensive action. They were theologically sound.
Show me where it says
I'm not going to show any verses.
But you don't know them. They were misquoted. Excellent. Well done.
There's one thing by Plato. Plato said something very interesting. He said, a fool speaks because he wants to be heard. A wise man speaks because he has something to say. Now, some people here, they're being foolish. They just want to be heard rather than having something viable to say. So I think they're actually taking this video to the wrong direction, which was supposed to be about Christian persecution.
Right.
They're not here to love.
I do speak for Christ. He says it's a parable. Open up your Bible. I don't need to give you a minute.
Tell me the process.
No.
Parable. How does parable work?
Right.
So you look at this part.
All right. Lots of love. Bye now. Okay. So Christian. Excuse me. Sorry. Christian persecution is what we. No. I've been right there, and now we've moved across it. Okay. I'll move over here. JC, would you mind just tilt in the camera this way?
It's funny how
Christian persecution. Well, I've only got 50% of. I think it's only Muslim women who only have 50% and are deficient in religion. Excellent.
You know what it is?
Hypocrisy. Anyone who wants to know, Luke 19:27 is part of a parable. Jesus
how?
Is
how? How
because
work?
Jesus how? Says it's. How does the process work? Well, yeah. Sorry for
something,
anyone who.
Something they don't like.
Let me answer then and get out of my space because social distancing. Get out of my space, bruv. Because you're getting on my nerves. That's the answer. You're getting on.
The Bible's getting your nerves.
No, not at all. The process of parables, for anyone who's like slightly backwards. The point is, heckling is so embarrassing by people who are not funny. Listen, dude, shut up. How about that? You are. Talk to him somewhere else. The point is that our parables are an illustration of language and stories. Display an ethic or a moral or a hidden meaning. But in the Bible, Christ says, I have not spoken in secret. So all parables are explained like a paragraph down. Christ will say, and this is the meaning of the parable of the sower. This is the meaning of the parable of the minas and the king. So in that verse, Christ's words, which are noted red, I don't care about your first question. Christ, I really couldn't care less, bruv. The point is that Christ is quoting a king.
Let's get to the conclusion.
Okay, excellent. Okay. All right, so this is the wrap up. I'm not here for this guy, although he's certainly here for camera time. I'm here for Jesus, and I'm here for anyone. Like, there's people in the background there who have sensible questions, even though we all have our passions inflamed. Honestly, the London in me is strong at the minute. So the point is that Jesus, I don't care for your questions, sir. I'm doing a wrap up. And he's also with me. So I'm speaking for him because I have authority in Jesus. Of course you can. All right, Mr. Brown.
Can I do my conclusion before you get into... No, forget Mr. Brown. He's just here to distract. Peace and blessings of Christ to the so-called audience. So thank you once more. And Brother Marty that sent me this tweet, just remind, because she was talking about parables, my Twitter is just purely for allegories. I'm just trying to show people their idols in worshipping things like Donald Trump, worshipping Boris Johnson, worshipping conservative parties and all these foolish parties. And we also, on my Twitter, I'm very, very certain that, fortunately, some of the guys that actually come on my Twitter, you actually ask me intelligent questions. And one of them, Marty, you sent me a message. And this message was very important. Let's talk about persecuted Christians. We were talking about the persecuted Christians, and like I said, I'm not going to spoil the blood of martyrs, by talking about foolishness with people that choose to be ignorant. I'll go back to what Plato said. Plato said something. A fool talks because he wants to be heard. A wise man talks because he has something to say. Now, what is the importance of me mentioning this? Well, what happened in Christchurch was a very horrific and sad event. The guy got paid and he's now sentenced to life in prison. He murdered a lot of innocent people. Now, what's happened in Sri Lanka is that 250 Christians were murdered, 750 were maimed. And none of these guys are getting justice because seven of the ISIS guys, only two are getting convicted and five are getting released. And we need to know what we have to do to ensure that people that are murdered are actually given justice. We cannot use religion as an excuse to kill people innocently. We cannot use ignorance as an excuse to stifle voices that talk against condemning actions of barbarity. Now, when somebody takes a truck, rams it into a church, and blows up people on Easter, and they say Allah Akbar, who are they referring to? We have given you citations. Quran 9:29, Quran 8:12, there are many verses that talk about this antichrist doctrine of Islam that is brought to destroy the Christian faith. Revelations 12:17 is the biblical prophecy of Islam and its assault on the saints. We call on people to repent. That is what our job is as Christian missionaries. If you don't want to hear our report, my blood's not on your hands. This is why I'm very clear to get this message out. Because one day on judgment, God will ask, what did you do? I said, I tried to talk to my Muslim brothers. Most of them ignored me. My hands are free. Now, a lot of these guys here will come up with unnecessary conversation to die and divert from the true topic. But we ask the audience to pray for those persecuted Christians all around the world, whether it's under communism, whether they're subjugated, or under Islamic doctrine, where they're murdered, raped, and brutalized, or the other kind of situation where all these... Now, you see the derogatory methods of the Mohammedans here, and this is the Antichrist spirit. Who is a liar but he that denies that Jesus is a Christ? The Antichrist, and that's the evidence. He's just been lying. God bless you all, and remember, stay away from Islam, as the apostate prophet says.
Right, lots of love. Oh, Mr. Brown, I'm sorry, I was about to go and... Brown, do you have a question?
Let me say to Mr. Brown.
You say Jesus is both man and God, right? Yeah. Isn't that a hermaphrodite or androgynous?
No.
Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Okay, anyway, I'll come back. Oh, no.
How can you just say no? Come on.
Easily, because the answer is no.
But it's already in its finger. You say it's both man and yes. God, yeah? Yes. So a hermaphrodite or...
two separate natures encompassed in one human body. So there's one human male body, because none of us believe in the transgender stuff. It's a male body, and the word became flesh. It didn't become a male and a female, a God. And even if it was, even God and man does not make you a hermaphrodite, because God is not a method of reproduction. So he's not androgynous either, because that's to do with gender and sex.
So the word Jehovah and Elohim, yeah, both contain masculine and feminine gods and goddesses, yeah? So it's plural, yeah? So it can both mean...
Yeah, the Holy Spirit is referenced.
So within that word there is androgynous.
I'm going to answer you, yeah? Because God is neither male or... excuse me, you're still interrupting. This geezer is camera hungry. The point is that it's an imperfect method of describing the indescribable. So Allah is technically neither male or female because he is like spirit. Do you see what I'm saying? So if something is purely spirit, it has no sex or gender. Whereas Christ alone of the Godhead became human and he became male.
But you Christians believe...
Yes. The dual nature...
The beginning was the word.
Yes.
The word took on flesh.
Big up, John.
You believe that God took on flesh.
Yes.
So that God,
the word, yeah.
The word, Elohim, or
yep.
Jehovah.
The one who the Father calls God flesh, in Hebrews, yeah.
When he became flesh,
yes. He was male.
By that word on its own, we understand that to mean androgynous.
No, we
meaning,
don't. We don't.
So, I know you don't. But the people who received the message understood it then.
But
so we're talking about the Kabbalists and the Jews. So they understood that.
And the Messiah is understood by the Jews understood, to be eternal.
They understood that exactly, and not a dead Messiah. So the Messiah, you say that was Jesus, it's not that one. But let's not divert, yeah? So what I'm trying to say that is, what I'm trying to say that is, you guys don't understand it, but what the people who received the message, the people who received the message understood it that way, that their God is a judge of us. Yes, yes.
We'll disagree. So the divinity is not a separate form of gender. The pronouns that we use are earthly. And when we say the Father, everybody thinks of a father, and yet God is unlike any human father in that respect. He is more than any kind of father. He has eternally been the Father. There was never a time when he became the Father. There was he was the eternal Father to the eternal Son with the eternal Holy Spirit in constant and divine communion.
How can he be referred to as the firstborn of all creation?
He's referred to as the firstborn over all creation, so that's a slight pickup. And because David, if you remember, I don't know you up in your Bible, David is referred to as the firstborn of kings. He wasn't even the firstborn of his brothers, and he certainly wasn't the first king. So it's a position of honour. It's not.
Jesus created by God.
No, Jesus is the creator according to the Bible. Okay. Yeah.
Which verses that you have to say that Jesus created?
All things in John 1. Nothing was created that was not created by or through him, and Hebrews says that all was created by him and for him.
Is the word Trinity in the Bible?
No, the word Godhead is in the Bible. It has the same meaning.
Okay.
Excellent.
So was Trinity made up?
No, Trinity was already a word, and it was used to refer to the Godhead.
Okay. So what about in the Old Testament where it says that God is not a man?
It's saying that he can't lie. God is not a man that he should lie. So it's not saying he's not a man, it's saying he's not a man that he should lie.
And what about the commandments?
What about?
I have no gods other than me.
There aren't any gods other than him. He knows of no other gods and he's all knowing.
So there is.
There aren't. No, Satan is referred to as a god with a small g. We're talking about divine gods, though. We're not talking about the gods of Baal and that sort of stuff. We're not talking about false. Sorry, we're talking about genuine gods.
Jews believe Yahweh had a wife named Shekinah.
No, they didn't. No, they didn't.
Yes, they do.
Excellent.
If you look at their teachings.
Not the teachings. Show me in the Bible. Let me just come back to this gentleman. Mr. Brown, please. Please. Not Jewish teachings, Jewish scripture. There's a difference. There's no. Excellent. It's not in the Bible.
Well, do you pray to Jesus?
I pray in the name of Jesus.
In the Bible, it does. He was asked, "How do we pray?"
Yes, and he gave the Lord's
prayer. Did he give instructions to pray to himself?
To the Father. And he also but he also says that you ask for in my name, you will be given. So I just told you, I pray in his name to the Father.
He directly said to pray to the Father.
And he directly said, "If you pray in my name, it shall be given."
Okay.
Yeah, Jesus wasn't an atheist. Of course, he's going to tell you to pray to the Father.
But he wasn't.
The Father also, the Father also searches the mind of the Holy Spirit who indwells us, and the Holy Spirit prays on our behalf to the Father.
When Jesus was taken by Satan,
yes,
in the desert,
yep.
He said that all of these cities
could be yours.
Could be yours.
Because he is the God of this system.
How could Satan offer that?
Because he's the God of this system. Because he's the God of this system. Yes.
So how can Satan offer someone that's you?
By the permission. By the permission of. If you look at the book of Job, it should be explained. By the sovereign means that you give authority to you. Nothing happens outside of God's will.
So you say, do you believe that Satan had sovereignty?
He has dominion. He doesn't have sovereignty.
So you believe that Satan had the power?
I believe that the Bible tells me that. I'm answering him. But I'm just giving him the Bible, and he's coming against me. What I believe? I believe the Bible.
Yeah, me too.
The Bible says.
But I'm trying to understand how Satan could say you can have all of these principalities.
He's the father of lies. I'm just going to point that out. And a murderer from the beginning.
Okay, but he's the creator of all things.
So Jesus is the creator of
all things. Temptations. Can God be tempted?
No.
So why was God being tempted in the
he
desert?
He wasn't tempted.
He was trying.
But it says that he was.
No, Satan attempted to. Jesus didn't consider his proposal.
Yeah, but if he was God, Satan would know that this person cannot.
Satan knows, and he's doing it because he's in the earth and he's been made lesser than angels. This is the Bible. The Bible doesn't say that it's without contradiction for a start, and it's not a contradiction. A contradiction would be if Satan would have come up to Christ and said, "I know you're not God." That's a contradiction, because we know that Jesus is God.
What about when one of the scribes or Pharisees, they asked Jesus, what is the greatest commandment of all?
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, strength and mind, and love your neighbour as yourself.
Okay. Now, if you're reading that...
And that encompasses the entirety of the law.
That, yes. And you don't have any idea about Trinity.
Yes.
It say
or
Trinity
Godhead.
Bible, you don't have
the
any
Godhead,
idea about concept.
1 John 5:7. Okay. You do have an idea of that concept. You're misrepresenting the Bible.
If you're reading this passage...
Are you a Unitarian?
And Jesus himself says the greatest commandment is to love the Lord God with all your heart and all your mind.
And love your neighbour as yourself. Yeah, because that, and then he goes on to say, no, because you're cherry picking. He goes on to say, and this encompasses the entirety of the law.
Okay, so if you're reading that and you have no idea about
then you better get an idea.
You have no idea about Jesus being God.
Right.
How can you?
You're not reading the same book then. All right, I'll answer you.
If you're says that Jesus isn't God and he is commanding you, the best commandment.
John 1, 1, no.
We just love God.
Okay, excellent.
He didn't say, I am God.
Bro, can I speak? Are you a Unitarian?
Are you a modalist? I wouldn't like to say because
you're not a Trinitarian. That's for sure.
You want to find out what my religion is?
No. I want to believe. I want to find out what your interpretation of the Bible is, because the same Bible that you say, let me ask you though, if you're reading the Bible and you don't know that the Bible says Jesus is God, you're not reading the same Bible as I. I'm going to give you the whole list of verses. 1 John 5:7. There are three in heaven that bear witness.
To me, a prophet is a messenger for someone, right?
Yep.
So you say to me, go over there and tell someone something, right? Now, if I am his messenger, then how can I be him at the same time? It's a contradiction.
John 1 answers you. No, John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was... Excuse me. Take it up with John, mate.
Okay,
listen, it's God breathed. No, you can't. I've got the mic and it's right in front of my mouth. It's right in front of my mouth. If you think Jesus is the Father, you've got issues. The point... Wait, I just want to answer this guy's point. So if you think that the Godhead is not referenced specifically as three, 1 John 5:7, you've got John 1, you've got every single book of the Bible has Jesus in it, and the Father sends him in John 3:16. Hold on, there's many. There's just too many. What is your point?
Well, when the scribe asked him, what's the greatest commandment?
Yeah.
At no point did he say...
The Lord your God. He doesn't say, I am not your God.
Do you think that scribe walks away believing that Jesus...
It wasn't
was God,
a scribe.
Or a Pharisee, whoever it was. Yeah. It doesn't matter. Do you believe that person walks away from that conversation believing that man he just spoke to is God?
I believe lots of Jews believe that Christ believed himself to be God because they kept picking up stones.
Do you believe that man is...
I don't know.
You don't know, but you
I don't know.
That you interpret reading that, from reading that. You.
I'm listening to Christ's words, not the man's inner thoughts. I don't search the hearts of men. God alone does. This guy wants to revise the Bible and have some sort of commentary in there to make it simpler. No, that's true. You said it's a bit vague.
He could say you're revising the Bible.
It's God breathed.
What is vague is your passage that you have given. I've got the why Jesus is God. If we listen to exactly what Jesus says himself.
Yeah. I am the living God, you mean?
It doesn't say
in the Aramaic plain English Bible in Matthew 14. Do you want me to bring it up on camera? I'll put that up on the edit. Hang on, excuse me. Matthew 14:27. Fear not, for I am the living God, in the Aramaic plain English Bible.
I have two questions. When Jesus puts his head to the ground, who is he putting his head to the ground for?
He prays to the Father.
The Father.
Yes. He's always been in communion with the Father since the beginning.
And he's been in
communion. Why would he stop talking to him while he's on earth? Right. He's giving an example to others
carefully,
also.
Carefully, I'm listening to what you just
excellent.
Said. I'm carefully listening to what you just said. Right. You said he was in constant communication with the Father, right?
Yes.
The Father is outside of time, right?
Yes.
The Father is all-knowing, right?
Yes.
Can the Father be flesh?
The Father can't. If anyone sees his face, they will not live.
They will crumble, yeah?
Well, the whole earth, or the mountains will crack and everything.
Why? Because he's a big ball of light that nobody knows.
I wouldn't put it quite like that, but he sends the Son and he sends the Spirit.
He is the Spirit?
No, he isn't.
All right, cool. So Jesus puts his head to the ground.
What verse are you referencing?
In the Bible, it doesn't say he puts his
head to the ground. I'm asking you. Also, are you including the times when he looks heaventward and no birds peck his eyes out?
No. There's a specific line that I've read before.
But what about the times he prays... other than prostrating?
Yeah. What I know of the Bible is that there's different versions. and there's the red Bible.
What about when he looks up to his father and speaks and says, share with me the glory? Yes, the red letter Bible. Yes, I've got it.
What is the red letter Bible?
It means every word of Christ is in red lettering.
Just his words, right?
Yes.
And in the red Bible, does it say that? Does he say that I am God?
Yes.
He says, I am God.
Yes, he says, before Abraham was, I am. That's good, not God.
Why call me good?
Anyway, where's Jesus?
That's what Jesus said with his own
words. Excellent. And he doesn't say,
only God is good.
And he doesn't say, I am not God. Don't you understand? All right, I'm going to do a wrap up. I do have to wrap up because I would like a cigarette, if that's all right. Excellent. It doesn't make sense to you. Pray for some discernment. Anyway, JC, over here, bro.
Oh, that means
only God is good. Only, no, in other places he says it. So anyway, Jesus is Lord. I will show you. Matthew 14:27. No.
No.
No. Answer, what faith do you have?
He believes in God.
Do you deny Christ?
I'm talking about the Bible and what Jesus says.
Excellent. But
and
you said
want to
you
talk
believe
about
in the
me
Bible.
Personally.
You said you. Yes,
Let's
I do.
Talk about what Jesus
no,
says.
No. I'd like
Let's
to ask
have
you
a look
at
the
question.
Bible.
Okay, you don't
want
to
don't
engage.
Want to question the Bible.
Excellent.
I want
I don't
to engage
need
about
to.
The Bible.
It's God breathed.
I want to
it's
engage
God
with you
Excellent.
About the
right.
Bible.
I'm not available at the moment. Okay, so God bless you all and see you next time. Bye-bye.